And as you relinquish, we move right in, Durward.
You're ready with the song, I presume?
I presume I'm as ready as I'm ever going to be.
You're ready.
We're in the money. We're in the money. Yes, we've got a lot of what it takes to get along. We're in the money. And the skies are sunny. Old man trouble, you are through, you've done us wrong. We never see a headline about a bread line today. And when we see the landlord, we can look that guy right in the eye. We're in the money. Come on, my honey. Let's spend it, lend it, send it, rolling along. We're in the money. We're in the money. Ooh, money. Yes, honey. We never see a headline about a bread line today. And when we see the landlord, we can look that guy smack dab in his good eye. We're in the money. Come on, my honey. Let's spend it. Let's lend it. Let's spend it, lend it, send it rolling. Hey, long.
I guess you could call this the age of diplomacy, couldn't you?
Well, this is certainly an age when we need diplomacy. That's an established fact.
Yeah, this is the age when diplomats are very active.
Very few diplomats laying off these days.
Thriving business.
It's a growing business, too.
Oh, there's new men rushing in every day. Some of them haven't even had time to get outfitted in frock coats and striped pants, and they sign them up, send them out.
Haven't even got silk hats and attaché cases.
Oh, yeah. Because of the rush, many of them are working in slacks and sweaters. Sports shirts, you know, sneakers, anything.
Well, it's a sneaky business sometimes.
You're full of those things, aren't you?
Well, just so they're being diplomatic, that's the main thing.
Anyway, the reason I brought this subject up is that I thought you fellas and our listeners might like to know that blue is the favorite color of diplomats.
Interesting. Blue is a diplomatic hue, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And what about blue jeans for the diplomat, since his favorite color is blue?
That's a good idea. Blue work shirts with sleeves rolled up and blue jeans.
This is building.
Rosie, where'd you pick up this information on diplomats preferring blue?
From Mr. Bertram Wheel, manager of the Tuscany Hotel in New York.
The Tuscany?
You know it?
Know it. I think I owe it. Got a trunk in there.
Yeah. Listen,
no, it isn't. I stand corrected. If it isn't the Tuscany I owe, I don't think it's it's the Etruscan.
Oh.
That's where my trunks are gathering dust in a cool, dry place. Very empty trunks. Full of newspapers, old copies of Variety.
Heavy, yes. Anyhow, according to Mr. Wheel, as far as hotel rooms go, diplomats like a light azure shade.
Mm-hmm. Diplomatic blue.
You know, the Tuscany has an individual color scheme for every room, and they can provide a room for every color taste. How about that?
That's a colorful service, I'd say.
I wonder what shade actors like.
Actors?
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, an actor likes a room with the rent shaded a little.
Oh, I see.
You know, a little courtesy to the profession.
But what about the color?
Oh, hang the color. Who cares? The rate is all we worry about. And can we sign in the tab in the dining room? How far can we go in the bar?
And will they hold your luggage in a cool, dry place?
You know, don't you? You know. You've been around.
Back to the colors now. Beige is the color of honeymooners.
Is that right? Beige for honeymooners?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And yellow for children.
Uh-huh.
And get this, fellas. Coral pink is the preference of leaders of American industry.
Well, think of that.
Executive pink, huh?
Match their blood pressure.
They're all a little choleric.
And here's a service that you can get in very few hotels. They can change the decor swiftly with the aid of fast-drying paints. You might check into a green room and go out to lunch and return to a gray room.
Well, but then if you don't like the gray, you can always phone room service and order it changed to cerise, can't you?
Oh, sure. Anything you want. Just name your color.
Well, how nice.
Be a good way to gaslight a guy, wouldn't it? Change the color of his room every time he went out.
That'd really cause a fella to flip.
I think I'll see if I can get a hold of Alfred Hitchcock. Gee, this is a plot for a picture if I've ever heard one.
Okay, you phone Hitchcock and I'll sing a song.
Fair enough. I'll get a hold of Hitchy right away.
What is there to say? And what is there to do? The dream I've been seeking has, practically speaking, come true. What is there to say, and how will I pull through? I knew in a moment contentment and home meant just you.
Remember when it was stylish to be stout?
Oh, but now we know it's downright dangerous. Because those extra pounds make your heart work harder. They increase the chance of heart trouble.
If rich desserts are piling pounds on you, try delicious low-calorie dessert of puddings instead. Creamy, smooth, chocolate, butterscotch, and vanilla flavors.
Yes, and so rich tasting, you can't believe they're low-calorie. Yet because dessert is made without sugar, a serving has fewer calories than half a large grapefruit. Deserta gives you all the goodness of a sweet, nourishing dessert without the extra calories you get in regular puddings and pie fillings.
Try delicious Deserta gelatin desserts, too. Only 12 calories a serving. Look for Deserta, D-Z-E-R-T-A, in the low-calorie section of your grocery store.
Remember, Deserta is made without sugar to let you enjoy luscious desserts with a clear conscience. At mealtime, bedtime, anytime.
I say either, and you say either.
You say neither, and I say neither.
Either.
Either.
Neither.
Neither.
Let's call the whole thing off. I like potato, you like potato.
You like tomato, and I like tomato.
Potato.
Potato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
But oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
Oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So if you like pajamas and I like pajamas,
I'll wear pajamas and give up pajamas. For we know we need each other, so we should call the whole thing off. You say laughter, and I say laughter.
You say after, and I say after.
Laughter.
Laughter.
After.
After.
Oh, let's call the whole thing off. You like vanilla, and I like vanilla.
You sarsaparilla and I sarsaparilla.
Vanilla.
Vanilla.
Pistachio.
Strawberry.
Let's call the whole thing off. But oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So you go for oysters, and I'll go for oysters.
I'll order oysters and cancel the oysters.
For we know we need each other, so we better call the calling all off. Let's call the whole thing off.
You know, there are lots of annoying things you can ignore.
Like my singing.
Oh, don't butt in. And after a while, you do forget them. But you can't ignore miserable cold distress. You want to relieve it fast. To do that, listen.
Imagine a famous singer trying to make a hit recording when he feels miserable from cold and sinus trouble. He needs relief in a hurry, right, Frankie Lane?
Cold, sinus, and singing sure don't mix. To feel better fast, I take the newest medicine for those miseries, new improved four-way cold tablets. New four-way contains a decongestant to drain sinus congestion while it relieves cold distress.
Clinical tests prove four-way acts faster than any other leading cold or sinus tablet. In minutes, four-way speeds pain-relieving medicine all through your body. In the same time, there was no trace with other brands. Only four-way starts so fast to relieve muscular pains, reduce fever, relieve headache without upsetting stomach. And four-way drains sinus congestion to restore free breathing.
You're so right. Four-way is really great and really fast.
To relieve cold miseries while you drain sinus congestion, get new four-way. Fastest acting of all the leading cold and sinus tablets. New improved formula, same familiar package, only 39 cents.
Come hither, stare. That strips my conscience bare. It's witchcraft. And I got no defense for it. The heat is too intense for it. What good would common sense for it do? 'Cause it's witchcraft. Wicked witchcraft. And although I know it's strictly taboo, when you arouse the need in me, my heart says yes indeed in me. Proceed with what you're leading me to. Such an ancient pitch, but one I wouldn't switch, 'cause there's no nicer witch than you.
Fuse must have blown. I guess you better hold my hand. Oh, ouch, doggone. Who left that closet door open?
I don't know. Oh, thank goodness. There, the lights are back on.
Oh, yeah. Boy, did that ever hurt.
No wonder you bumped into the door. There's no room to squeeze by. Tell you what to do about it, Bing.
About this barking shin of mine?
No, about that open closet door. Replace it with an Easterner folding door. It's ideal where a regular door cramps your space.
You know, I might just take that advice. Tell me more.
Well, the Easterner, offered in fashionable colors, is made of flexible, full-length steel panels, laminated between two layers of washable vinyl. It's a snap to install and costs only $9.95 at department and drapery stores everywhere. And Bing...
Yes, Rosie?
You won't get any of this with an Easterner folding door. Its heavy-duty track and nylon slides operate smoothly, luxuriously, quietly for years. Made by Eastern Products Corporation of Baltimore, who also make the famous Eastern Weave Lifetime Woven Aluminum Folding Door. It's excellent as a room divider, a backdrop, or other smart home decorating effects. If you want the name of your nearest dealer, just call his station.
With a dream of love, I can face the world without you. With a dream of love, I remember the sweet things about you. When I'm awake, I know that we're apart. But in my dreams, I guess I'm not so smart. So I close my eyes and I hide from all my sorrow. When I close my eyes, there's a promise of maybe tomorrow. I believe when they say that dreams come true, with just a dream of love, what else can you do? Just a dream of love. What else can you do?
And so we conclude for now. We hope you enjoyed what we had to sing for you and what we had to say.
Hope also you'll be listening again tomorrow. Same time, same place.
When kids used to stick pins in doorbells and chalk up windows on Halloween? Well, those stunts are out of style now, we hope. Next Tuesday evening, as in recent years past, youngsters will be ringing your bell asking for a trick-or-treat for UNICEF, the United Nations Children's Fund. Give them your pennies, nickels, and dimes. They'll help needy children all over the world.